Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are listening to John Gillis Entertainment from. Here I'll give you hundreds of all the trends happening in Nigeria, Africa, and globally. Please, for those that are new, make sure kind enough to hit the subscribe button and the bell notification. And feel free to share this video on any of your social media platform. Don't forget to hit the like button too. So many things have been happening in the entertainment industry. Congratulations to you, Fireboy DML. We have this good news from at official chat that already an Afrobeats legend at Fireboy DML gains his first ever UK top 10 hits today with a little help from Ed Sheeran. Big ups to you, Fireboy DMA. We really love that song, Peru, Para. That song is lit. It's been making waves globally. Young musicians are doing very well. I mean, they're dropping his songs, doing their best to put Africa or to put Nigeria, not just Africa, Nigeria on the world map. They've been doing very well, polishing our image on the world map. That is a huge one. The Davido, the Burna Boys, the Fireboy DML. The list is endless. We have so many hot artists in this beloved country, Nigeria. Big ups to you guys. Well, talking about one of the hottest artists in Africa right now, Wizkid. Wizkid has been doing very well. In 2021, in one of my videos I dropped, Wizkid won 35 awards in 1 year, and nobody has ever done that. Nobody has ever achieved that feat in Africa. Congratulations to you, Wizkid. No doubt, Wizkid is the hottest artist in Africa because of the awards he has won so far. Fine, he won a Grammy Award with a song he did with Beyonce and Blue Ivy. We really want him to come with the Grammy Award in 2022. We're still talking about Wizkid. As I said earlier, he won 35 awards in 2021. This is 2022. And this is 9th of January 2022. We have this news that the year is just starting and Wizkid has already bagged 2 awards. Culture Custodian Awards, Artist of the Year and Project of the Year, Made in Lagos. The project Made in Lagos is lit. And we should know that Made in Lagos was released in 2020 and is still making waves 2 years later. That album is definitely a classic hit. As I've been saying in most of my videos, I don't skip any track of that album. I've been listening to the album back to back. But basically, my best album, or my best track rather, of the album Made in Lagos is the one he did with Damian Marley. Blessed. I really love that track. But big ups to Wizkid. But we know that the song that's been trending of that album, the Made in Lagos album, is the one he did with Thames, the Essence, and the remix he did with Justin Bieber. Wizkid is definitely a living legend. He's a giant when it comes to entertainment. Be dropping his songs back to back. Congratulations to you, Wizkid. We can't forget the drill. But I mean, Wizkid has so many hits. So Wizkid, watching when he was performing at the O2 Arena, the United States of America, so many states in the US, and when he came back home to Nigeria, Lagos, Abuja, Warri. Big ups to you, Wizkid. I mean, he'll be doing very well. He has so many hit songs. We're still talking about Wizkid and one of the songs of his Made in Lagos album, Essence. Someone dropped a message at Olamide Official, said, Essence is now eligible for 2x platinum in the United States. Biggest African song ever. Yeah. Essence is the biggest African song ever. And this Wizkid's Made in Lagos album is lit. And we know he has a Made in Lagos album, the Lost. We can't wait. This is 2022. And Wizkid has promised to release another album. Less Ego. We really need more love, less ego. I mean, because of the insecurities we'll be having in the country. Big ups to you, Wizkid. Keep winning. Well, I saw this picture, you know, for those that love movies, that love Hollywood movies of Denzel Washington. You know, Denzel Washington is one of the hottest black artist in Hollywood. He's been doing very well. I mean, I love his movies. Can you name this movie? Don't forget to drop a comment on the comment section below. Let me drop this as an assignment. Have you seen this movie before? What's the title of this movie? Don't forget to drop a comment on the comment section below. Let us move on to another part of entertainment, sports, football. AFCON 2021 has started in Cameroon. Cameroon are hosting the AFCON 2021. The AFCON tournament begins today in Cameroon. The last time Nigeria won the AFCON, it only came through this man, Stephen Keshi, though he's late now. Stephen Keshi captained the Super Eagles to AFCON crown in 1994, coached the Super Eagles to AFCON crown again in 2013. Stephen Keshi remains the only Nigerian and the second African to lift the AFCON trophy, both as a player and a coach. Now, Egbavon has taken Austin. Egbavon, though he played with Stephen Keshi when he was alive, when he was still a player. Now, Austin Egbavon has taken the Super Eagles to AFCON 2022 in Cameroon. Do you see Eguavoen making it to the finals with the Super Eagles squad? You know, in one of my videos I posted, I asked if people thought, if you think Nigeria can make it to the finals, can they make it to the semi-finals? And by the way, do you think the Super Eagles will bring home that trophy? We really want to see that, to see that trophy. We haven't seen it for some years now. We want to see the AFCON trophy. Do you think the Super Eagles will win AFCON 2021? Don't forget to drop a comment or what you think on the comment section below. Well, as I said earlier, the game just started. AFCON just started. And according to results, Cameroon plays Burkina Faso and they scored 2-1. Yeah, Cameroon, the host nation, they won 2-1. And Ethiopia and Cape Verde played 0-1. Cape Verde won Ethiopia. Well, we'll be giving you updates on all the matches. According to analysis, when during halftime, Cameroon was already leading the game with 2-1 against Cameroon. Do you really think those guys will carry the trophy home? Talking about AFCON, we have this news that NFF to pay the Super Eagles $5,000 for each group stage win. Wow, $5,000 each. That's a huge one, but man, these are players are they are already made. But I think this is like a boost to help them deliver their best during the tournament. The Nigerian Football Federation has agreed to pay the Super Eagles the sum of $5,000 for every win during the group stages of the African Cup of Nations, built to kick off on Sunday. Yeah, it just kicked off today. Nigeria's first play is against Egypt on Tuesday. Do you really think we'll be able to win Egypt? Remember, Mohamed Salah is in Egypt, and that guy has to do very well. Well, big ups to all the AFCON players. Well, still talking about the host nation, Cameroon, who are hosting the game. Vincent Aboubakar with 2 penalty goals to stay on advantage 2-1. So I said earlier, Cameroon just won the match 2-1. Vincent Aboubakar scored the 2 goals on penalty. He has now scored 27 goals in 79 games for Cameroon. AFCON 2021. Some persons have been saying Senegal will go home with the trophy, while some people have been saying Cameroon will go home. And some people, you know, Nigerian fans have been saying the Super Eagles will come home with the trophy. Do you really think we have what it takes to bring the AFCON 2021 home? Don't forget to drop a comment on the comment section below. We're still talking about the match against the first game between Cameroon. We have this news that Steve Yago registered the first yellow card of the tournament AFCON 2021 after the tackle. It took him less than 1 minute to do so. He got a yellow card 45 seconds into the game, less than 1 second. Well, that is football for you. Talking about the game, you know, women have been doing very well in football, in sports, like in countries like the United States of America and Canada. You can't compare their female teams to their male teams. They know how to play football. Well, we have this good news that meets Salima Makansanga, where they set to become the first woman to officiate as center referee for the history of AFCON. Wow. She'll be international football referee from Rwanda. Salima, they part of 4 female officials who will officiate for the tournament. She done referee games for Olympic, FIFA Women's World Cup, African Women's Cup of Nations, and CAF Women's Champions League. Big ups to you, Madam Salima. This good news, you know, this good news indeed, because so many ladies have been complaining that they are being, you know, sidelined or segregated by the male gender. Yeah, they want equality. Big ups to you. We hope you do your best. And she has officiated in big games, you know, the Olympic, FIFA Women's World Cup, African Cup of Nations, and CAF Women's Champions League. She really has what it takes to officiate in the
AFCON. Thank you very much for watching your latest entertainment. We hope you entertained. Please make sure you drop your comments on the comment section below. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button, the bell notification, the like, and feel free to share this video on any of our social media platforms. And please, who do you think will take home the AFCON 2021 trophy? Make sure you drop your comments on the comment section below. Take care of you and have a lovely day.